Hello everyone, as you know, we are reading the chapter number 12 of class 8 mathematics, that is the exponent and power. In our previous video, we have already discussed the introduction of it and the laws of exponent also. Today, we are going to solve the question of exercise 12.1. So let's see, we have the first question is, evaluate the first one 4 to the power minus 2. Right? So as we know by the laws of exponent, we have a to the power n minus n. In that condition, it will be equal to a to the power a divided by a to the power n. So by this law, we'll write that 4 to the power minus 2 as 1 by 4 to the power 2. Now 4 to the power 2, we know that is 4 square is 16. So answer for this question will be 1 by 16. The next question we have is 1 by 2 whole to the power minus 5. Right? How we will solve this? We'll use the law, that is a to the power a divided by b whole to the power minus a. In that condition, if we exchange this numerator to denominator and denominator to numerator, then power becomes positive. That means this b will be b divided by a whole to the power n. Okay? So like this, we'll get that 2 by 1 and the power will be positive, right? Now 1 to the power 1 is what? 2 to the power 5 divided by 1 to the power 5. So 1 to the power 5 is equal to 1 and 2 to the power 5 is equal to 32. So this is how we solve the question. Okay, let's see. The second question we have is the simplification. Simplify the first one, minus 3 whole to the power 4 multiplied by 5 by 3 whole to the power 4. Now here the powers are same and here this 5 by 3 will be simplified. So if the powers are same and the base are different, in that condition we multiply this base and we write the power as whole. Like for we have a to the power m multiplied by b to the power m. In that condition first we multiply this base, that is a into b and whole to the power m, we will write. Okay, now we will see here, according to this, a we have minus 3 and b we have 5 by 3. So this we can write as minus 3 multiplied by 5 by 3 and then whole to the power 4. Okay, then this 3 and minus 3 will be cancelled out, 3 1 and 3 minus 1. So minus 1 and 5, so that will become minus 5 whole to the power 4. So this will be answer for this. The simplification will be minus 4, 4 to the power 4. The next one we have 3 to the power minus 7 divided by 3 to the power minus 10 whole multiplied by 3 to the power minus 5. So first we'll solve the inside the bracket as the base are same and the powers are different. So e to the power m divided by e to the power n. This is law which we'll use here and that is equal to e to the power m minus n. Because the numbers are in division form, so in that case the powers subtracted. So here we'll get what? We'll get 3 to the power minus 7 minus here the second power is minus 10 and then whole divided by 3 to the power minus 5. Now if we solve this, this will be minus into minus, that become plus, and minus 7 plus 10, minus 10 plus 10, that will be 3. So this will be 3 to the power 3 multiplied by 3 to the power minus 5. Okay, now again we have the same base and with the product. So as we all know, a to the power m multiplied by a to the power n. So that become a to the power m plus n. So division will be there. So in that time we'll subtract the power. If product is there, in that time we will add the powers. So 3 to the power 3 and plus minus 5. So that will be here this 3 is positive and this minus 5 is negative. So 3 and minus 5 will be subtracted, right? So we'll get 3 to the power minus 2. This will be the simplification of this question. Let's solve the next type of question. Here we have evaluate a. We need to find the value of this equation. This value of this expression here a is equal to what? Minus 2 by 3 whole to the power minus 2 and whole to the power 2. Okay, so how we will solve it? We know a to the power n whole to the power n. In that condition the power multiplies. So e to the power n into n. So here minus 2 by 3 pulled to the power will be minus 2 into 2. So this will be equal to what? Minus 2 by 3 divided by 2 to the power minus 4. Now here this power is negative. So we'll convert that into positive. So we'll change this numerator to denominator and denominator to numerator. That means we get 3 by minus 2 and 4 to the power 4. And this will be answer for A. We have used the law A by B and minus N. So that condition will be B by A and 4 to the power N. This is what the laws we have used here. So the answer for this will be equal to 3 by 2, 4 to the power 4. Then the next question we have is 8 to the power minus 1 into 5 to the power 3 divided by 2 to the power minus 4. Now see, here this 8 can be converted as 2 to the power 3, or 8 we can write as 2 to the power 3, and this 2 by minus 4 is in denominator, so we'll apply here e to the power m divided by e to the power n. So first of all, what we'll do is, first we'll convert this 8 as the base 2. Right? So 8 will be written as, 8 can be written as 2 to the power 3. Now here, this 2 is base and also here. So this we can write 2 to the power 3, 4 to the power minus 1 multiplied by 5 to the power 3 and 2 to the power minus 4. Okay? Now this 3 and minus 1 will be multiplied because here, as we same law, a to the power m, 4 to the power n, so it will be a and 2 to the power m multiplied by n. Okay? So this 2, 3 multiplied by minus 1, so that becomes minus 3 into 5 to the power positive 3 and 2 to the power minus 4. Now we'll simplify this 2. So what will be 2 to the power minus 3 minus 4, okay, multiplied by 5 to the power 3. Okay, now see, if you solve this, minus 3, minus and minus, so that become plus and this 4. So 2 to the power minus 3 plus 2, so 2 to the power 1 multiplied by 5 to the power 3. This will be answer for this question. I hope you are getting it, right? Just simplify it, minus 3 and minus 4. So on upper side, it is in the division, minus 3 minus minus 4. Okay, so minus minus plus, so that become minus 3 plus 4. So minus 3 plus 4, if you simplify that, we get plus 1. So 2 to the power 1 multiplied by 5 to the power 3 will be the answer.